Very heavy object, mate. It's called a Schutzen dumbbell, which is normally, and you can see it's a Schutzen dumbbell, the way it's pressure of his neck there to take the weight on. It's very, very heavy indeed. But round of applause for Sweet Dog there, doing retrieving. Well, you do make mistakes, don't they? Have you ever seen people walking down the road with a right arm out here, their backside out there, the dog pulling the dog? Like that, they go faster and faster and faster. Think about it, you only say heel when the dog's in the right position. Well, you left me. Don't change, but it's out there, but that's where it always begun. It's the same with toilet training. How many people mess that up? Let's not a pun, but how many people have messed that up? Go on this one. They get a puppy and they say, had an accident. No, he's been to the toilet. He's a bad dog. No, he's been to the toilet. I have to do a little survey now. Say, put your hand up if you've been to the toilet today and you got told off. When you go out, doggy logic, isn't it? And then we come back 4 or 5 hours later and say, who did that? Yes. You see the point, don't you? Okay, have a look at this new exercise. This is all based on teaching the dog to do different things. And this is about the socialisation as well. Are you ready, handler? Where you go. It's a simple exercise, over the chair, over the chair, over the chair. Now the dog has to be trained to do this. Because the average person puts something in front of the dog and says, over! And you can see the dog's actually ridiculous, I can walk around it while the dog's jumping. This Charlie, as I say, he's taking a few, can you see the border collie go? Border collie skin's coming out there, look. He's now challenging this dog here. Now this dog here has genetic aggression. He wouldn't back away from a fight. And he doesn't fight to fight, he fights to kill. He's got genetic aggression. So there's a whole lot of difference. The little Yorkshire Terrier, the tough nut of the dog world terriers, aren't they? That's what we've bred. Little Maggie Moo. Squeaky, this dog. Gonna make somebody the nicest pet in the world one day. Well, we'll see. So have a look at this now. What would your dog make of this? For some dogs, you've only got to get up quickly from the sofa and they go, what was that? So we teach these dogs to accept almost anything that happens. Have a look at this. What would your dog make of another dog jumping over? Excellent. They all stay there and they all get a little reward for it. So well done. So we do vary everything we teach, which is very, very important. Dogs need stimulus. You know dogs are right and left-handed, did you know that? That's quite professional. You know what eyebrow they raise when they approach you? If they're right-handed, they raise a right eyebrow, if they're left-handed, they raise a left eyebrow. Now you're laughing now, thinking you're making this up. Absolutely true. Dogs are right and left-handed, and as they approach you and see you, they will raise a particular eyebrow corresponding to the right and left eyebrow. It's how it works. And it's amazing how many people don't know, after 15,000 years, these dogs do this. How many people know why a dog yawns? Stress. That's what it is. They'll sniff the ground, occasionally they'll scratch if they're stressed out. A lot of people say, well, he's tired. It's a little bit of stress going on, and that's what that's about. Now we have another gentleman from the services here, Petty Officer Chef. from the Royal Navy, Scully Smith. He's written these words, good looking, good cooking. You decide. Anyway, Scully, good to see you in the team. Are you ready? This is just a little bit of fun for two terriers, teaching them to ignore each other. Because you know and I know that if you've got a terrier, at some time it's probably going to dissect Nick Thor's cat. And then go back to the rabbits and the guinea pigs, because they're a terrier. And when they go head to head, it can be a problem, because they're not like border collies, fight your backside 15 times in 10 seconds, and fight it once in 3 months. So we've got to get these guys to ignore each other. Are you ready? Demands, contents, go! A little bit of a race going on here between the Yorkie and the little Jack Russell Cross. That's good. That's what we're looking for. Oh, she's having a look around him. Somebody's got a camera over there, because that was a serious pose for Mr. Mackoff. But at the moment, she's behind everybody. We're going to speed her up a little bit, but the race is on back into the wheelbarrow. And the winner is Ollie, the Yorkshire Terrier. Well done, Ollie. Good boy. You probably gather by now, we don't teach tricks in the centre of the world. It's a little bit of a message, isn't it? To get people to understand dogs a little bit better and have that much nicer relationship with them. Because we can cause problems. There's no two ways about it. By the way, this is Scully, Petty Officer Chef from the Royal Navy. Does he do well with those chairs? When you break on the frame, no, he's much more superior than that in the cooking in the cooking world. Something that always worries me is when people openly teach aggression to their dogs. Now you know and I know that every dog has aggression. You know every person has aggression. Every child, every cow, every animal life. It has that aggression which is just below the surface. Certain things will bring it out quicker. I know certain men, you could poke them in the shoulder a few times and then run. Another person, you poke them in the shoulder once and they're quite a big one. So it's corresponding to the dog's nature. Have a look at the wagging tail, which is extremely important. That dog is wagging his tail because he is very, very angry at this place. Now, this is not protection training. This is prey drive. This dog will bite. We've taught him now to bite on command. Not because he feels like it, as he was in the past. What he used to think is, that run, I bite him. Where did it come from? His previous owner, every time the postman knocked, used to go, Bitter. And the dog used to bark, but the postman was going anyway. And the dog was like, okay, come on, little guy. The next day, the postman came, had a parcel, the postman went. The third day, the postman came, had a parcel. The person opened the door, he barked, the postman didn't go, so he missed him. He said, right, that's the little dog, get out of here. Instruction order was given to us to rethink his way, or retrain his mind, and now he fights on command and only on command. He's not going to walk up and chomp people. But have a look at this, because inside his padded sleeve is a lump of scaffold tubing solid steel. That's what he's biting on. So once you've seen this, if you are thinking of going home, wrapping a towel around your arm and say to your dog, bleh, that won't last half a second. He's going to be biting on solid steel. But think about it, he's going to be running at 20 miles an hour, throwing his whole body weight against that scaffold tube and fighting it. Could you do that? No, you'd not be wasting it. So please never, ever, ever, ever encourage aggression. Leave it to the service dogs to do what they do best. Okay, are you ready? Watch this, you're never going to outrun him for a start. Now, that dog only weighs about 2 stone on the back. The man weighs about 12 and the dog stopped him easy peasy. Now, this dog could keep this behaviour pattern up for at least an hour. A human on a bare arm would last roughly 2 minutes. So it's something you should never encourage. He's still got that aggressive drive there. You can tell by the way he's wagging his tail. But the command was, what we don't do is go, because the dog says, well, you're getting aggressive. We can both kill this meeting. Seriously. You watch people with fighty dogs. When the dog starts showing aggression, they go, pick it up, stop it! And the dog goes, yeah, great, you're joining in. You've got to remain calm, you've got to remain relaxed. If your dog is doing a behaviour pattern you're not happy with, give him or her an alternative. Get something else to them. Chase a ball or something. Make them rethink it. Now, I can see there are a certain amount of dog trainers in this audience. How do I know? Well, I got my first dog in 1943, which is a few years ago now, and I can smell dog trainers as well as dogs. Seriously. You may not agree with what you're doing, but for me it's worked nearly 70 years, so it's a method I've stuck with. Getting dogs to understand what's expected. This is a Malinois, or Belgian Shepherd dog, one of four of the breeds of the Belgian Shepherd dog, or four of the models for the one for it. Now, this dog is so up on fighting control. You can see he's standing there with a simple saddle. Now remember, this is in every dog's mind to do this, because genetically they all have a prey drive. There are certain dogs that will chase a squirrel, kill it and eat it. And there's probably only two of them, and that's the terrier and the lurcher. And that's a dog that will chase from the squirrel or the rabbit. This dog's drive is absolutely immense. Now, he's got one thing in his mind, and that's the bite. This young mug man, sorry, up here, he's going to stick with it and try and get that dog, would you believe it, to run between his legs, when all he's got in his mind is to bite. And the bit about it, the bite mark, comes here. So if you all see that. And the dog will be here with his mouth wide open, about to give enough power to take a house brick in half in one bite. Shouldn't send it in the first place, because it can be a major liability if a kiddie was to jump in here now and run between the dog and the criminal. You've got to be able to stop them. Have a look at this. We hope it's going to work for the man on the register. It's important. Send your dog. He's gone through. That's what we want. He's now biting. And you watch the feet going round the leg. Can you see the feet going round the leg? The dog is pulling his quarry on. He's now in the stage of what they call the main bite. And it goes further. If he holds onto the leg, then that would be the kill bite in real life from the days when they were hunting for their feet. That's his reward. He gets an alternative to biting that guy, but the control is important. So can you now switch your dog off, Amber? And we'll ask this young man to stroke him. Very important. Now these dogs are not like the German Shepherd, who are much friendlier than this particular breed. These are very, very, yeah, if I were a